Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's time for a volcano update, but I've not done one in a while since there wasn't that much material to work from. Just ground uplift as usual, but the Met Office came out with some new information today, saying that the magma info is not as stable as it has been. And we did actually see that as well before the last eruption. So the question is, could it be that the lower magma chamber is powering down because the flow up to the upper magma chamber isn't as stable as we have usually seen? And again, I think it's a reason to ask, could this be the first sign that this is coming to an end? Although I think it's way too early to be speculating, and we still think that eruption number 10 is on the way. But when, and the Met Office is saying that by mid-November, we should start to be on the lookout again. But given how the time between eruptions has been getting longer and the eruptions are larger, in addition to perhaps not as consistent magma inflow, we might be looking at the next eruption taking place in December, even January. So this time frame is still very open. So I'm sticking to my original prediction when I said that the next eruption would be in November or December, although it is still a bit early to say. But I do have some good news, not just for Icelanders, but also for tourists, since the town, Grindavik, will be reopened on October 21st in a few days. And isn't that just a nonsense, might one ask? But I'm saying no. We have had year to prepare this. The most fractured and dangerous areas have been sealed off, so there are still restricted areas there, but there are no restrictions when it comes to restaurants, which is good news for the tourism industry that ceased to exist in the town almost a year ago. And the tourism industry nationwide, it has also seen better days. And it might have to do with the negative press we have been getting, and often incorrect. But as for this town opening, I'm very happy to see this, to see some life in the town again. And this means that I will be visiting Grindavik soon, maybe even during this first day of opening. So right now I'm planning a trip to the Reykjanes Peninsula. And I will also use it to do some thermal scans around there. And although I have been in Grindavik every now and then, I've only had limited time to work with. So I would like to fly over there and go after many of the details I want to have documented, and give myself time to move after photo and video subjects. And coming into town, being able to go into one of the cafes and get myself a cup of coffee, like in the old days, it's just good for the soul, and also for the soul of the town. But when we get closer to the next eruption, I expect the town to be evacuated again. We are more hopeful that the worst is over by the town itself. At least we hope so, and as for other activity under Iceland, I hardly know where to start. I've been seeing the strong spikes of unrest coming and going, and I've been having this feeling that we might be in for something new soon, not necessarily on the Reykjanes Peninsula, like the huge volcano Bárðarbunga was shaking the other day, and I was actually driving nearby that volcano last summer, filming, but the footage was unprocessed, so I took that folder and finished it, just to get ready for more news. And shortly before that, Hofsjökull Glacier was also teasing us, so I had already processed that folder, since I was also filming there. And a week ago, Askja Volcano was sending us a quite strong earthquake swarm, so I went searching for that unprocessed folder and got it ready. So this unrest has made me process most of the volcano footage from last summer due to this unrest, and I have to say that if I were to make an non-scientific guess, I would say that Askja will be the next major volcano to give us a hard time. The ground uplift there has been going on for over 2 years now, and the increased earthquake activity, it could be telling us that this sack of magma under there is filling up, slowly but surely. But it's not for me to say though. But I can say that when I drove by Asker recently, I was filming the area around and I would like to fly over that area in a plane, suitable for filming, to try out the new camera I have. And if you want to know more about that, check out my recent video where I'm talking about the channel and the projects I have. And it is, of course, stuffed with the footage that I haven't published before. But as for the whole country, it's kind of hard to figure out what's going on. I've been looking at the seismometers almost daily for a long, long time. And although I'm not a geologist, I know what is normal and what is a bit off. And the whole country seems to be a bit off. So it would not surprise me if we would get more earthquake activity soon. And there are still unwritten pages about the year 2024 when it comes to the geology of Iceland. I'm sure about that. But let's do some other news. First, the bad news. I crashed my DJI Air 3 drone the other day. Only me to blame during a landing. And the DJI Iceland, they just called me this morning with the damage report. So it's on the way back to Iceland now. And that drone that is responsible for lots of footage on my channel, it will from now be my backup drone because I'm getting myself the new DJI Air 3S model that was only released yesterday. And I'm doing this mainly for the larger sensor that handles a low light better. And believe me, we need that here in Iceland, especially this time of year. So I have already listed my old DJI Air 2S model for sale. But that has been my backup drone since I got the Air 3 last year. So this is a good upgrade. If everything is right that I have been reading about this drone, I would have liked to get myself a more professional drone like the Mavic series, but it's a bit too much for me now. And the extra batteries and the remote I have from my old Air 3 is compatible with the new S model, so I don't have to get myself all the parts that I got last year. So this upgrade is not very painful for my budget. And even if you are visiting mostly for the volcano updates, I do advise you to check out some of the new series that are coming because they have a lot to do with the geology as well. And I've been using this time between eruptions to get the first such videos online. Or as I've been saying all along, I only just started. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.